This is ZNS Total Sports, brought to you by Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Hi, good evening, and welcome to Sports Sunday. I am Julian Gibson, Marathon Bahamas, taking place this morning, and you had runners from all over the planet. How did the race go for you?
Good. Yeah, it's a great race. Started off wet, but finished nice. Yeah, it's great.
I see you moving back and forth. Look like you're tired, you're exhausted.
I'm done.
I'm very happy to win today with such weather. It's our first time in Bahamas because we are from France.
First time in the Bahamas and first time winning.
Yes. So, but I hope it will be sunny so that we get home for holidays.
You look like you're in good shape. Was it difficult? Was it hard?
No, I was managing the race because next week we are running the half marathon in Miami.
So you do this all the time?
Yes.
What do you think about the whole course?
Was it beautiful?
The race is quite flat, but the two bridges are quite difficult. But it's okay, very well organized, so we're very happy to run here.
Not bad. Got some pretty good rain between three and the third and fourth miles, raining pretty hard. But then it stopped off. It's really humid this year. But other than that, good.
Shifting to baseball, the Junior Baseball League of Nassau had their official opening ceremonies yesterday. It was well attended. Genesis Junkin' Group also providing the music. And when it gets down to competition, the coaches, all of them say, they hope to win a championship for 2016.
We have a pretty good team. So much so that we look forward to taking the championship this year. Last year was actually the first time the Distributors made the playoffs. And actually after the season, we signed the song, started from the bottom, now we're here. So we're actually looking forward to a very good season, a competitive season, in which the championship, we look forward to grasping the championship this season.
Seeing that we're the defending champions, we know that we have a target on our back. But our team is relatively new and young, so this is more like a developmental time. But as we always do, we put our best foot forward and try to win the championship and improve people's skills in the sport.
Let's raise some funds for this guy. No, we don't have to, because I think it's Ralph McKinney dressed like that because it was mucky. The area around the field events. They had long jump, shot put, races on the track. All of the athletes trying to be like Shawnee Miller. And judging from yesterday, we just might be on target.
I was watching you run, you really good run. Girl had the lead on you. Did you think you could catch her? So you know you could catch her. You was training hard. You was practicing hard. So you could be good when you grow up. Ain't nobody could beat you. They ain't ready for you in. Boy, you look good running your race. You had fun?
Yes, sir.
How it feels winning?
Good.
How was the competition out there?
Great.
You like track and field?
So.
So the next Olympics, that's our next 4 years. You could be running for the Bahamas, right?
Yes, sir.
What you could get, a gold medal, silver medal, or bronze?
Gold.
Now for Foster Dossett, meet organizer. He was pleased with the turnout.
Well, it's usually the first meet of the year. Every year for the past 20 years we've been doing this now, and it's obviously the first regular meet of the year. The odd distance is the first meet, but this is the first regular track meet with the one, the two, the four, and so forth. And I think especially because it gives the coach and athlete an opportunity to see where they are at this stage of the season.
When we was coming in, boy, we see a lot of vehicles, boy, it's well attended.
Yeah, the usual is, you know, because like I said, being the first meet, parents want to see what their kids can do. Coaches want to see where the kids are with their conditioning. And I think it's kind of special to us because we want to be the first out of the block.
And finally in sports, some shaking and baking from basketball. C.I. Gibson senior boys, they recently returned from Las Vegas. And they might be better come Hugh Campbell time.
Man, listen, that trip, my team grew up on that trip. And, you know, very young team. And that team realized the importance of urgency of getting better as players and as a team. We really bonded on the trip. We saw DeAndre Ayton over there. He's dominating the level of play. You had hundreds of Division I kids, Division I coaches in the gym, and the level of players there's on another level. So They understand the importance of getting better, understand the importance of staying in the classroom academically if they want to play college basketball.
Well, that's all the time for Sports Sunday. Once again, I'm Julian Gibson. Stay tuned. Your better forecast is still to come.